Well, obviously what it was is they were getting the lights turned on the K5. You see those little red lights he's got up in the grill area? Doesn't help the race car go any faster, but it looks cool, so we'll give him benefit of the doubt. 8 laps the distance, we're ready to go racing with the modified streetcars. Side by side, they work off into turn number 4, looking for that elusive green flag, and we are gonna wave it, and we're gonna go racing. And the 15 will pull out to the lead. Colby Taylor took the spot away from Rickett. Rickett will answer back on the outside. Chris Rickett on the inside, Colby Taylor on the outside. Side by side, they go off into turn number 4. Rickett will take the lead on lap number 1. So Chris Rickett showing the way. Colby Taylor second, Brad Davis is third, Brett Banks sitting in 4th. Rickett in the 36, showing the way down the front stretch and into turn number 1, 2 laps on the scoreboard. Well, the headlights aren't paying much dividends for the K5 machine of Blake Kelly. That car was sideways in turn 4. Rickett doing a great job holding off Colby Taylor and pulling away from that second place car. We'll be halfway next time around. 4 in the books and 4 to go for the Chris Rickett machine. Colby Taylor running in 2nd, Brad Davis 3rd, Brett Banks 4th, David Bullington running in the 5th spot, Cody Thompson 6th, Blake Kelly 7th, and Logan Cobb is 8th. Checkered flag, Chris Rickett picking up the win. 2nd place going to Colby Taylor in the 15. Brad Davis 3rd in the 88. Brett Banks 4th in the 3. And 5th was David Bullington in the 20. That'll do it for heat race number 1. That means Chris Rickett will be on the pole in the number 36. Heat race number 2. Set. Green flag will come out for heat race number 2. Your leader, Austin Neely, will show the way in the 3 car. Nick Presley in the 69 in that 2nd spot. It's Dale Reed, 3rd and 52. Now to the outside comes Presley in the 69. Can't quite get the bite off the corner, has to tuck back in line behind Neely. Two cars have pulled away. Austin Neely and Nick Presley. And Presley continuing to work the high side of the racetrack. Neely comfortable on the bottom. The run is in turn number 3 for Nick Presley. Just can't get off that corner. 2 in the books. Now make it 3. 5 to go. Halfway next time. Leader Austin Neely looking to get the 2nd starting spot here tonight with the victory. He's halfway to getting that accomplished. Distant 3rd, Dale Reed in the 52. little further back is Mike Williams in the 119 and RJ Mays in the 6M as they continue to battle. Austin Neely now opening up the advantage as two to go, white flag the next time by. White flag next time by. White flag in the air, one to go. Austin Neely in the three car, showing the way. Checkered flag away, Austin Neely will take it. Coming home second will be the 69 of Nick Presley. Third's gonna go to the 52 of Dale Reed. Coming home fourth, RJ Mays in the 6M, and Mike Williams finishes fifth. So the winner of heat number two coming to us out of Rogersville, Tennessee. Austin Neely taking the checkered. He'll join Chris Rickett on the front row of the main event for the Modified Streetcars. Third and final heat for the Modified Streets in staging. Kurt Owens in the 14, Tony Horton in 56, Willie Bussler in the 3, Jonathan Miracle in the 21. I believe Caleb Trent will be in 3. John Cook in the P21. Caleb Trent in 3. John Cook in the OZ. Vic Chandler in 88. Bill Curl in 57. Winner will start third this evening. So that will be up for grabs. Third place on the line. And they're ready to fire off that fourth turn. They look good. We're gonna see green, no doubt. No doubt, no doubt. And that's exactly what happened. Everybody punches the time clock and goes to work, and it's gonna be Kurt Owens showing the way. Tony Horton into 56 in that second spot. Now a challenge for third. Bussler to the inside of the P21 of Jonathan Miracle. This a year from now when you can't carry him no more. You watch. Watch if I'm not right. Hold him now and enjoy him. Here we go. And the green flag is out. We're back underway. Once again, Kurt Owens in the number 14 will show the way, but here comes the 56 of Tony Horton. And Horton losing ground down the front stretch as the power just not there. Very good through the corners for Horton, just not able to keep up in the straightaways. Good battle going on right now for the number 5 spot as the OZ machine of John Cook is in a tight battle, and he'll take over the number 5 spot. He'll set his sights on Bussler in that fourth position. And it is all Kurt Owens right now in the 14. We'll be halfway next time, 4 in the books, 4 to go. And smoke coming out of your leader. There may be a problem developing on Kurt Owens' machine. We'll see. He's got 4 laps, making 3.5 now before the checkered flag. Well, good battles going on behind the leader who continues to show signs of smoke. He's got 2 laps left to finish it. And caution is gonna come out. That's not gonna be good for your leader. Kurt Owens needs to get to the pit area and fix what is ailing that 14 car. This time, your leader Kurt Owens gonna bring him up to speed. Tony Horton right behind him. Here we go. Well, the smoke continues to fly out of the 14. Everybody trying to take advantage so far. They have not been able to. 2 to go signal when they come around. White flag the next time by. And now the smoke really coming out of the 14 car. Kurt Owens showing the way, but something going wrong. The OZ of John Cook, the Oz Machine, now going for the number three spot. White flag in the air. More smoke comes out. And there's a fire underneath that 14 now. That car's on fire under the hood. We're going to get checkered flag, and the safety crew's going to have to go right to it. Checkered flag is out. He'll win it. And it looks like the fire may have put itself out. Kurt Owens may have won the battle, but we're not sure if he's lost the war. Owens wins the event, but at what cost? We'll have to wait and see if that's going to affect him or not. Some serious smoke followed by a little bit of flame under the hood on the white flag. He was able to finish. We're just not sure exactly how much damage was done. So four more positions now up for grabs in this consolation event or last chance showdown.